This is the collaboration panel. So what you will see is a collaboration in many ways between the seven of us.
I'm Tristan Tales, come from Los Angeles, and I'm here enjoying the sunny day in London.
Were you here yesterday?
Yeah, I got in yesterday.
So the true London summer.
Yeah, I saw the true London summer yesterday.
Yeah, great. Cool.
It was like it was sunny, and then 5 minutes later, it was pouring rain.
Yeah.
I've never seen so much wet stuff fall from the sky before.
Yeah.
It's tough.
It's a lot. Next.
Hi, I'm Evan, and I'm from West London, and I've been making videos for about 8 years. And
don't do the accent.
You're from America.
Be honest.
Hi, guys. I'm Evan. I'm from New Jersey, and I'm really excited to be here to visit all of you British people.
Can you
and
do a New Jersey accent?
That's what I'm doing right now. This is my
Hang
standard
on, but
American.
But that doesn't sound like Snooki.
Oh. All right, guys. I can't do that. It's not a real accent. She's from New York. Anyway.
Crazy.
I'm excited to be here. I make travel videos, and I make pun videos, and videos with Daniel J. Layton for views, and
Thanks.
Luke for love.
Less views.
Less views? you? Please.
Hello, my name is Luke Cutforth, and I... Wow, no woo. Did you see that? Nothing.
Woo.
Anyway, thanks.
More?
A bit more, yeah, no.
Or,
anyway,
or less. Or
I make literally whatever I want to make. I don't have a genre. I don't have a style. My only rule is that every time I try and do something a little bit different. And so...
Seventh Q&A?
No.
Very different.
Right, thank you. And I'm also making a film, and I upload occasionally.
Hi, I'm Amber Doig-Thorne, and I do comedy sketches and pranks sometimes, mainly comedy sketches.
Hey guys, I'm Altoria. I'm a YouTuber, and I do beauty unboxing videos.
Fine, cool. Hello, I'm Ricky Dillon. I'm a YouTuber. Oh, thank you. Thank you. I'm from Los Angeles, and I do just whatever, kind of like Luke, just whatever videos I want to do, I guess. But I guess like comedy lifestyle, if we put a name to it, but yeah.
How do you approach other creators when you have when you want to collab with them? Do you have any like sweet lines that you like to give, or is it generally people that you already know? Do you have a process?
Food.
What?
Food.
Great.
Packet of Haribo.
Packet of Haribo. Any advance on Haribo? Any filet mignon? Any?
Your demographic looks pretty sweet.
What?
Demographic? I approach them with.
I can't hear.
Statistics and
great, good. Anyway, I want more on this Haribo. Which kind of Haribo?
Oh no, like, oh my gosh, it's got to be like the fizzy one.
Tangfastic.
Tangfastic. That absolutely.
Yeah.
I sometimes find it sometimes quite daunting. Sometimes, especially if they're like a larger collaborator, and there's little me, I'm like, oh no. But I often find that if you just be yourself and just be real and not go after like their views, then that's probably the best thing to do. Because at the end of the day, they're just like human beings, and I just think being yourself, really. What about you guys?
Yeah, I think I always give them a way to say no. Like, I'm never just like, let's collab. I'm always like, totally cool if not. Don't about to say no if you don't want to. But I try to always give them an idea. Like, if you just say, like, let's collab, it's harder to, like, actually get it done. But if you, like, bring them an idea that you think would be good to do with them, then that usually works out. So
do you tailor that idea to each person? Do you have, like, a format of collab that you like to do?
I try to, yeah. Yes.
Cool.
Yes.
Cool. Any more on that, Taylor?
That's really it. I just feel like if you give them a way to say no, they don't feel pressured and awkward. So as long as you're, like, don't worry if you don't want to, I'm just, you know, asking. And it usually works out. Yeah.
It's like asking someone out, basically. Like, I like you, but if you don't have to like me back, that's
fine. Yeah, yeah.
Fine.
Do you ever worry about... So what's interesting is that you talked about like little old me versus a bigger content creator. For me, part of the reason that I generally don't ask people to collab is this is all on me. This is my fault. This is in general. I worry about like coming across as a social climber. So have you ever like... How do you think that... Is there a weird power dynamic that we have or like...
Like, I've had it a lot where people will email me for a collab and you can tell it's just a super generic email. And it's literally just like, hey, love your content, want a collab? And I'm like, okay, they've probably sent this to like 500 other creators. So if I'm approaching someone, I always try and say, look, here's the idea that I want to do to you. This is kind of tailored to you, your content, your audience. Here's what I can bring to the table. Here's like the value that I can bring. Obviously, I want to work with you because you're a great content creator. I think you have to make sure that it's like a collaboration is a two-way road and you both have to be bringing something to the table.
Now that's interesting to me. About is there?
I have another point that I forgot.
Please.
I never ask for, like, I mean, the typical collab is, like, both channels, you know, obviously, but I never ask for, like, that. I'm always like, I have a video I want to do for my channel. I'd love to have you in it. And if they don't bring up their channel, that's fine. I still want to make mine. But then if they want to do another one, they'll be like, let's do one for my channel as well. So that's always, like, a big...
Less stressful.
Yeah, because then if they don't want to do their channel, but they can still do yours, like, it, like, works out usually. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Because that was what I was going to say. Is there something in... How do we feel when it's like, hey, I want to collab with you, but they're like, cool, I will collab with you on your channel and nothing else. Is that a thing that we're okay with?
When I first got started, and I had much less followers than some of the people that I collaborate with, but I'd bring something different to the table, and I would actually make content specifically for them, kind of making them the star of an idea that I had. And it was completely tailored, whether they wanted to do the idea or not, it was up to them, but I'd actually like write out a full-on concept for them. In hopes that they would like it enough for me to be able to make it for them, and then I would just be sort of like a sub character in it, making them the star. That sort of took on, and then eventually I was able to do it, you know, for myself and put myself as a star and bring in other people to be characters in that. So, like, curating content specifically for somebody that you want to collaborate with is another way to collaborate, especially if you're like much lower, you have like a much smaller following. This series on my YouTube where I have a YouTuber or somebody come live with me for a day, and I get to see what it's like to live with them, and that's just
that's such a good idea. I love that.
Yeah.
Wow.
Thank you.
Is it a way to keep your house tidy as well?
What's up?
Is that a way to keep your house tidy?
Yeah, I make them clean it.
You're constantly trying to impress. Oh, you make them clean it?
No, I'm just kidding.
Okay, funny. Oh, I would. Like, come and be my live-in cleaner for the day.
Well, I try to make them feel at home, so like I'll set up like a room that I think would look just like their room back at home.
That's uncomfortable.
Yeah, I know, it's super funny.
Also, like, mildly terrifying. If they walk in, you've replicated their exact bedroom.
How did you get this painting?
Like, right down to the detail. I like it.
Yeah.
Talk to me.
I once got an email from a group of YouTubers that were like, hey, we want to collab. We make similar style videos. They pitched a video to do on their channel that was like, oh, that's a pretty good idea. And they even then said, if you want, we can do this video on your channel. I went, all right, that's actually not a bad idea. And I was really excited about it. And I checked their channel out. And they had already just done the video that they'd offered me to do on my channel. So I was like, why would I do the same video? Your audience would be like, oh, I can't wait to watch that again with Evan in it on his channel. So it was very confusing. So I just ignored it. But it was a good effort.
Solid.
I also get email collabs sometimes like, hello, I am XX YouTuber's manager and he would like to collab with you while you're in California. And I was like, ugh. That's weird. I'd rather someone just meet me and talk to me and be like, let's
yeah, I will agree with that. Yeah.
It's just uncomfortable.
If you
want to
collab with someone,
involved?
I'll like DM them or something.
Yeah.
What I've done before, I've reached out to a large, much larger creator because we create the same thing in America, and we want to do this whole like USA, UK unboxing
in
an advent calendar way because they do advent calendar stuff. And I spent nearly £100 sending these bloody sweets to the USA. I sent them, and then she was like, oh, yeah, I've sent you a box. Didn't hear a thing. Didn't get anything. They took my £100 box of chocolate.
Were you more upset about the loss of the video or the loss of the sweets?
No, I was upset just that there was just a bit of a cheek, really, isn't
it? Well, now you've got a story time about them.
I know. Yeah. They've got, like, 2 million, so I don't know, maybe. But, like, I just thought, because I'm much smaller than them, it was a bit of a letdown.
In the teeth.
Yeah, and they were really, really keen, and they're like, yep, yeah, definitely want to do this. Spoken to the managers, and yeah, it was a bit of a letdown.
So what did you do as a result of that?
I chased them via email, and they didn't respond.
How? Oh, so they fully ghosted you?
They just got free candy.
Me.
Ouch.
Yeah.
I think story time is in order.
You need to make a video about it. It'll do well.
Take down.
Yeah.
19 minutes.
Do it.
How do you handle it if someone approaches you to collab and you like you don't want to do it? Do you have a line to let down easy? You said obviously to let give people the opportunity to say no to you. How do you say no to them?
I think it's like when British people ask you if you want to like visit, like, oh, you should come over sometime. And it's like, oh yeah, let's do that. Mm. When they don't actually mean it because you guys are cruel. And it's like that with collabs. So people are like, oh, let's collab. Oh yeah, we can do that. Oh, when are you in VidCon next? Oh yeah, let's do it then. I just don't.
Be like, yeah, I'd love to. I mean, not that I don't want to, but like I say I'd love to and like we'll work it out. Then like we just don't, I guess. If we really want to do it, we make it happen.
Sure. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I don't know.
So I collab with friends because I know we have chemistry, I know we work, it's comfortable, it's easy. Can you manufacture that chemistry, do we think? Is there something that you do that puts other people at ease, or when you don't know the person?
I always think it's so much easier collabing with friends. Like, I very rarely collabed with strangers, just because it's similar to what you just said. If you don't have the chemistry on screen, I feel like it's quite difficult to fake. And if you've met someone for the first time and you're making a video, people are going to be able to see that you don't really get on. So yeah, it's definitely easier to collab with friends. I think just have a conversation, figure out what you can do that will suit both of your channels. And the fact that you get on already, it's going to be a good video because you have good chemistry.
Right.
So maybe try to get to know people a bit before you ask for a collab is probably my advice.
I often find that the videos I do with my friends are the most enjoyable, and I watch them back and I just laugh. And even if it didn't get the views I wanted to, at least I've enjoyed it. I think part of YouTube and creating content is about enjoyment. If you're not enjoying it, you might as well not be doing it, because it will come across as fake and a bit, you know, forced.
Yeah, I totally agree. I have done some where we've met the day.
Right.
Because I used to do like collab months where I filmed a collab every single day, and it's really hard. I might do one eventually again, but... So for those, I had a few where I met the person the day we filmed. Thankfully, they all worked out. Manny Emuway was one. James Charles was one. We met the day we filmed, and now we're like really good friends. So luckily, it worked out, but it could have very easily been like...
Did you have a contingency plan in mind for in case it was absolutely dreadful?
What does that mean,
contingency? Well, like, so you sit down and go... So I did a collab-mas for Christmas. I did a one every other day, because I realized I would run out of friends.
Yeah.
So that's what happened to me. Popular.
Yeah, I had to like get new people, yeah.
Yeah, but so then you're like, okay, so this person I'm going to meet on the day, do you have anything like where you're like, okay, so I will make sure that I do this to put them at ease to get the chemistry in? What happens if it goes wrong? What happens if there's just no chemistry?
I don't know.
You were just lucky.
Yeah,
it just
worked out.
The video.
You just didn't upload it?
I looked at the footage and I was like, I can't upload this. It's
so what
really
happened
bad.
Then? How did
they
you tell them?
They hated me.
Oh.
I told them I couldn't upload the video, and
they
got so offended. And they were like, it's because you don't want to make a video with me. I went, no, obviously I did. That's why I filmed with you, but it just didn't turn out the way I thought it would, and it was uncomfortable. They still uploaded theirs, and then they were salty for like 2 years.
That's fine. What?
They uploaded their collab because
it was
one.
And then stopped talking to you.
No, they were just very salty. We're okay now, but I don't think they even think about this. But I do sometimes, because they were really upset because they took it internally and went, "He didn't like me. He didn't want to make a video."
Luke, how did it make you feel when Evan did that to you?
It wasn't Luke.
Good.
But yeah, it wasn't like anything negative. It's just you know what goes on your channel, and if it doesn't quite meet your standards, that's up to you. And I offered to do a different type of video, which I think is the best thing to do in that situation.
Yeah, I was going
to
say, if you are, yeah.
Yeah, like, why don't we do another one that'll fit, maybe? And they, like I said, took it so internally. They were like, no, you obviously don't. You're just trying to feel bad for me. And I was like, no. So
what was it? Was it just that it just didn't have a good vibe in the video? Like,
there were some certain jokes made that even I was like, oh, I can't do this. And also, it just wasn't funny. I never laughed. So I don't upload a video unless it's supposed to be funny, if it's not funny. So do you laugh at my videos?
Do I laugh at your videos? When I'm in them? Yeah. Do you want to have any like horror stories from doing a collab that they have to go up anyway? Because that's pretty like uncomfortable.
All the collabs I've done, I've been really lucky. They all went really well. Like, I really liked my video and I liked their video. And then I collabed with a friend, so I thought it would be fine. And we did a video for their channel and it was totally cool. And then we did a video for my channel, and it's the type of stuff that I normally do. But it was like a public interview, and I don't think they've ever done that before. And the footage was just awful.
What made it awful?
I think it's... So we were kind of taking it in turns, interviewing the public, and it is quite a daunting thing to do if you've not done it before. And the footage just wasn't quite... Like, they're a really bubbly person, but it didn't really come across on camera, and it was just a bit awkward, and it's kind of the same as what Evan said. Like, there were some weird jokes, and I was like, oh, no, I can't put that in.
It just didn't fit.
Yeah, it just wasn't quite right. So I said I wasn't going to upload the video, but let's do it again, and I just basically got ghosted.
Ooh. And did they upload theirs? Yeah. Or?
They uploaded theirs, and it was right. Like, it was a good video. That's why I was like, let's do another one. Like, we get on well, we can make it work, and they just ignored me.
Ooh.
I had a good video once where the collab went well. I was very happy with the content. And it was a lovely friend. It was one of the first times I got to collab with her. And my audience was mostly lovely about it. However, due to it being a popular video, I started getting a flood of comments like, who's this dumb bitch? And I was like, oh God. And literally people were so mean about her. Like, all the comments were like, I hate her. And she was like, I never want to do a collab with you. And I'm like, they're not my audience. They're SEO people coming in from YouTube. I don't know, man. So I just started policing the comments and deleting people that were being rude. But it was really uncomfortable for her to make a video with me again because she was so scared of the negativity.
Poor Dodie.
straight up bitch.
I have a horror story where I I was going to do a collab with a big YouTuber who, I don't know if they're here. Not in this room. Anyway, it was Evan. No, I was going to do a collab.
Stand up at the back. They're there. They're watching.
Hello. I nearly said their name. Anyway. And I bought a load of stuff we needed to make this video. And I traveled from where I lived in Sheffield all the way to London, which cost
sorry?
Me a... I lived in Sheffield.
No, I heard. I'm just sorry.
Oh, okay.
I wanted to do that my whole life.
Is anyone here from Sheffield?
Sheffield people.
Thank you.
Yeah, go and beat up Daniel J. Layton at the end. throw steel at him. Anyway, so I spent about £200 on stuff to make this video. At the time, I was like 17, so like that was crazy money to me. I was like, I'm so excited. Not that £200 isn't crazy money now. I just mean it was like more.
Well, with the Brexit economy.
Anyway, I traveled to London. He said he was on his way. And then he just didn't turn up. And I was just sat in London. I'd booked a hotel to make this thing.
I was sat in my hotel
for a day or two. That was actually the day me and Evan met. Because I then found out we were doing like that Jack's Films and Charlie Is So Cool like meetup. So it wasn't them, by the way. that's my horror story. Lost loads of money.
Yeah, and just sort of ghosted.
Literally just didn't reply.
Have you all talked since?
Sorry?
Have you guys talked since then?
He messages me. I don't reply.
Whoa.
Wait, so you were 17 then. How old are you now?
How dramatic.
24.
That's long. Yeah.
Whoa. I hold a grudge, Dan.
F***ing hell. Gosh, there's a lot of ghosting discovered. There's no etiquette among the YouTube community. This is poor form.
See, I would rather someone say no to me than do that. I'd rather them flat out be like, no, I don't want to collab, and then me like spend money, and like go somewhere, and then like not show up.
Especially to book a hotel room.
Yeah.
With a rose petal.
And I was also a child. I was 17. I was not an adult, I mean. I was not an adult.
Yeah.
In the big city, which I'd like been to maybe twice in my life.
Bless you.
Stood there with a camera, messaging, going, when you come in, it's okay if you're late. Don't worry about it.
I'm going to move on because I don't want to cry.
Yeah.
And I feel for you very much at the moment. I just want to give you a cuddle.
It's a hard time.
Going to move on. What are you doing?
I asked him to call the person up.
I told him who it was.
Okay, well, if there's enough to... Well, I'm asking a question. If it's important enough to Levin, I think it's important to share with the rest of the group.
It's on camera, Daniel.
Okay, then maybe we won't. Rhyme? Good. Anyway, the question was that...
It rhymes with sack flate.
Oh.
Ooh.
Anyway, carry on.
That was a spontaneous, genuine... Oh, I really enjoyed that.
Oh, I knew now, what it is.
There it is.
Sack plate?
Sack plate, yes. Very famous YouTuber, Sack Plate.
I know who that is.
Sack plate.
It rhymes with that.
No. Oh, it rhymes with that.
Apparently.
Oh.
They can hug it out.
Anyway,
good. Just want to shout out who it is.
I've accidentally caused drama and I don't like that, so I'm going to go away from it. Collabs are, in the playbook, they're like, hey, we'll do this thing and you can share audiences and you can meet, you know, new people will find your content. That's an amazing way to grow. I generally find that I do that and then the next video, I feel a lot of pressure because this whole new influx of audience has come in and then if you make a video and they unsubscribe, you feel very shit. So do you have a plan for what's next? Do you feel that too?
I've never thought about that before. Good point.
Okay.
I've never thought about that. I don't know.
You've never thought about it?
No. I guess a good plan is to just always make stuff you're proud of, you know? I mean, I won't upload a video that I don't like, so... Yeah.
I think the key is not to overload with the content. So let's just say you did a video where you went to a theme park and it went viral. I think the key is not to then go to like all the theme parks in the UK and create the same content. I think you need to vary it and make that new audience fall in love with you, and not just that one video.
Yeah,
I just don't think you should oversaturate that one thing. Do you disagree?
Unless it's like a series on your channel.
Unless
like
if
you
want that to become your entire brand. And
right.
If you only do that video and you become that type of YouTuber doing unboxings of that only thing.
Completely agree with that. So I do, like Christmas time, I do a lot of Christmas unboxing. So that's kind of my thing. So, but what I mean is that in between those videos, I'll put like my vloggy kind of videos and that. So there's other...
Just to show the variety.
Just to show that I'm not just doing one
thing. You're not a one-trick pony.
One-trick pony.
Yeah, it's a good content strategy in general.
Yeah. For example, I collabed with Jenna Marbles a couple years ago. It was so fun. We did prank calls, and it did really well. So I don't do prank calls ever. So what you're saying is I shouldn't do prank calls every single video after that. Because,
But a lot of people do. I've seen newer channels, and they just create the same content, and they wonder why they're not growing. It's because, like... doesn't taper off.
Nice bit of variety. People like variety.
Do you feel like the collaboration, like the there's a pressure to collab in order to be a bigger YouTuber or to expand your channel?
That's a really good question. As like a channel that's still developing, I do. I find that pressure all the time. I think I feel like, I don't know about you as well, do you feel that, you know, I should be collaborating more? But I often find it the hardest because sometimes you do reach out to maybe someone with a slightly larger audience and they just don't want to collab with you. And it's like, and it is stuff that are, you know, it will be suitable for both channels, but there is a problem, I believe, in the community where there is a lot of collaborators that don't want to collaborate, and it is there. I don't know if it will change as soon as I get bigger. I'm not quite sure, but there is certainly a pressure for developing talent to collaborate and other people not willing to collaborate, unfortunately.
Yeah, and it is the best way to grow, obviously, but there's other ways to, like, some videos can just pop off and you get subscribers from that. Like, I guess, like, following trends when you can help, but there's definitely, like, that pressure, yeah.
I think the biggest thing, if you can't collaborate, perhaps find something on YouTube that is being searched well. So
right,
use
like a
Trends.
Current trend, yes.
Yeah, like use Google Trends and then find like the similar videos that are being done and find that golden piece of content that's not been done before.
Yes, make it your
that's
own.
How I've grown. It's literally finding gaps in the market and just owning it. So going to the meta tags, ranking first.
You're
in
smart.
Them.
What's a meta tag?
Listen to her.
Sorry.
A meta tag?
A meta tag.
A meta tag.
Sorry, in your YouTube channel, in your
videos. I don't
know what that is. And that's literally, I've grown from strategy rather than collaborating.
I have noticed that when I do get a boost of subscribers, it's from like my own video that got like a good trend or whatever. Yeah, so.
Yeah, I think when I did that strategy, I grew 90,000 in like a month. So,
you're smart.
So I did that strategy and I'm still new to the game. I've only been doing it for like a year and a half. And that's how I grew. And this, I think that takes away from collaborating because I feel like I could do my own thing, enjoy it. And if so-and-so does not want to collaborate with me, then they can, I'm not going to swear.
It's like a saturation point when you've collabed with the same.
Yeah, me and Evan. People.
Who knows?
Right.
Yeah, I don't even know.
I feel like there's a good chemistry between you two.
What's that? Yeah,
tension.
I feel like
chemistry.
Really
okay, we live together, so
I'm like third wheeling over here.
Yeah,
I shouldn't have sat you next to each other. That's
right. If I make a video with Luke, there's like absolutely 0% growth from either of us.
Yeah,
because people are like that ginger kid again.
Do they still get viewed in the same way though? Is there?
I don't really look at it like that. I genuinely just go, I want to make this video with Luke because I think it'd be fun.
But like when I mean not necessarily in terms of numbers, just in response, is there still an appetite for?
Yeah, I mean, as long as the content's good and it's not just, here's my friend Luke and I laughing over tarot cards and random personality tests for 10 minutes and having actual no content in the video. Like, it's actually something happening.
Yeah, I think with my sort of strategy towards this is I don't really care about growth. I don't really care about collabing, so I don't really know why I'm on this panel.
because I find you attractive, that's
okay,
why.
Okay, thank you. You didn't pick the lineup, but thank
Did
you
not.
Anyway.
I was just trying to make you feel better.
That aside, because you said you feel pressure to collab, to grow, and I don't feel pressure to collab or to grow. I just want to make fun things. And if like,
Did you at any point feel that?
Yeah, in the past, right. I definitely did, and I just kind of don't care. Like, as long as I'm able to pay my rent and as long as people
so what changed
watching
that, then?
Enjoying it, then I don't understand what else matters.
Was there a moment where you went from feeling the pressure to feeling comfortable enough to not worry about growth?
When I stopped growing? No, honestly, I've never really... I say that I felt the pressure to. I felt pressure to. I never bothered doing it.
Right.
Like, I felt like everyone was going, grow, do collabs, do trends. But I've always just gone, nah. So, and it somehow it works, and I'm on this sofa, so cool.
You are. Look at you, there you are.
Thank you.
On that sofa, there.
No, I agree there. I think as you get older in the game, you kind of just don't care about, well, I think collaborating is really important, but I think for your own mental mind that I think just being happy with the content you're creating completely trumps, like, just collaborating. You shouldn't collaborate for the sake of collaborating just because everyone else is doing it. You should not feel pressured to do it.
I guess that ties back into the chemistry discussion we had earlier on. They can tell.
Yeah, like I collab with my close friends a lot because I like filming with them. I don't do it because it's a collab, but like I like to film with them, how like they talked about. Like, I just like filming with my friends. So
that's nice.
Better chemistry works.
I like that too.
Do you think of the idea for the video and then collaboration sparks from there? Or do you think, oh, that person's cool, I want to do a thing with them, and then think of the video based on that?
Like, I recently did Carpool Karaoke with James Charles because he's a really good singer, and I do like that as a series every now and then. So I reached out to him. I was like, hey, you can sing really well. I'd love doing this. So you want to do this with me? So I rarely will just be like, let's collab and then think of it. I have my idea of ready.
I think that's really important. Yeah. I think what's so off-putting is, like you said, get an email saying, hey, I love you, want to collab? And I'm like, well, you've not put anything to the table. If they like sent me like a really like good message explaining like, you know, what they can do, what we could do together, I think that's really nice. And just to mention, if you're starting your own YouTube channels out, there's actually a really good YouTube platform called FameBit, and there is a like collaborating section, so you can actually meet people online through the platform. So if like, for example, I live in the middle of nowhere, so it's really hard sometimes to get to London to network. So it's really good to actually go on this platform, and it is a YouTube approved one, and I think they own it actually. So just a little tip.
No wonder they approved it then, if they own the thing.
Do you feel like, to the LA people, that living in LA really influences the amount of collaborations and ability you have to make videos?
I mean, LA is full of tons of creative people and tons of content creators, whether they're emerging or have already gained a massive amount of success. So there's really like a huge pool that you can pull from. And there's a lot of places to film around town. So it's a really great place to network and to just, you know, get your creative on. Even though it's a huge community, everybody seems to know each other. So like,
yeah,
it is important when you are reaching out for your first collabs that you are making the right first impression, that it doesn't look like you're just using them for followers, that like you actually are looking at them as like there's something about them that you really like and that you want to showcase to your following, and there's something that you can add to their following. Because, you know, even though you might feel like a small fish now, you know, in a year you could be, you know, at the top, and everyone's going to remember that one time that you reached out to them, you know, a year ago or a couple years ago when you were a small fish, and, you know, you might have said something silly or whatever. But it's important to know that, like, the community's big, but it's also really small.
Yeah.
I think the key is actually to network as well, so not just stick to your platform. If you get offered to go to an event, go to the event, and this is how your everything becomes a small world, because these people are turning up to the same event over and over again, and you like go like upstairs, I go upstairs, like, oh, I met you here, I met you there. I think that's another really important thing, networking, and not just sitting on your ass and doing nothing.
Well, that's what I do.
Oh, really?
More often than not, I love to sit.
How is it working out for you?
It's marvelous. Sitting is my favorite activity, especially in this chair. I could have a little nap. Has anyone been reached out to by old media, like traditional celebrities and things like that, to do collabs with in some way?
I did one with Ollie Murs.
Oh, lovely.
Oh,
how
really
was he?
Good.
Was he kind?
Oh my God, he's amazing.
Ollie Murs is a pop star in the UK. For the LA contingent, Ollie Murs is a pop star.
We accidentally turned up late because there was traffic, and he was just so chill about it. He was like, no, that's fine. His management was a bit angry at
us. So what did you do with him?
So we did a blindfolded makeup challenge. So it was another creator and I, who's Chip Daddy. So he did Louisa Johnson, I did Ollie. And it was just so much fun. The chemistry, the banter was there. It was just brilliant. And we got approached by a company to do that, and Ollie wanted to do with influencers.
Did you have any nerves going in that
Do you know what? I was with like my really good friends, so I kind of felt really at ease. And I think doing it as a collaboration with someone else was actually really nice. I was a bit nervous to meet him because I thought, oh gosh, it's just little old me. But he was just so friendly, and the video was so much fun to do.
So Shay Mitchell, who was in Pretty Little Liars, my favorite show of all time. I'm obsessed with her. I collabed with her a few years ago. I just reached out, and she said yes.
Oh, so you went to her?
Yeah.
Great.
Yeah, because she does YouTube. So she is a YouTuber because she makes videos. I was like, I'm going to ask her. And she had started to do collabs with people I knew. So I was like, I felt my chance, you know, was there. And she said yes, it worked out, but I was so nervous. She came to my house. Like, I was freaking out. But it went really well. She was so nice. What was the question?
Just have you been offered them? Protocol? What does it feel like?
No, well, I asked
I'm just
her.
Interested that you asked because I was asked, and that she came to your home because I was asked if I wanted on my baking show one of the cast of Orange Is the New Black. Now I don't watch Orange Is the New Black, so I had no idea.
Good
but
show.
The logic with my head was, well, she'd have to come to my house and then be there for about 4 hours, and I feel like that's weird, and so I didn't.
Yeah, I like super cleaned. I cleaned everything. I made sure it looked nice, you know.
You would have made her clean it.
Yeah, she would have cleaned for
sure. Yeah, lovely, perfect.
Luke and I got an offer.
Yes.
Of?
From Millie Bobby Brown.
Oh my God!
They made us prepare a video.
One of the biggest stars in the world.
We spent hours preparing the video. It was really exciting. And then when was it?
It was about last year.
It was like 45 minutes before we were supposed to leave.
Sorry, yeah, and she cancelled.
She ghosted you as well.
I also got cancelled on by Yumi at 6.
Oh, yeah. That's a story time.
But I do have one planned with Jedward, so that's good.
Ooh.
I once went out with Jedward in Dublin. We were out in Dublin, and then Jedward were there.
Is Jedward not the moderator right now?
Oh, yeah, there he is. No, that's Jack Howard.
Who?
Exactly.
From Jack and Dean?
Oh, Jack and Dean. Oh, very funny. Evan, you may leave. So you also have done Celebrity X-Men.
Yeah, so someone from... I don't watch Love Island, so I'm not going to say who it is.
Are they here today? Sorry, but Love Island is still
Excel.
Here.
Yeah.
Have you not seen this? So right, I'm so sorry. We'll get onto that in a second. It's just that right now the XL is populated by YouTubers, Jehovah's Witnesses, and Love Island.
Weird combination.
It's like it's a classic joke. I don't understand. Anyway, you were approached by people from Love Island this year, or
No? So it was last year. I think it was like last year in January, and a mutual friend reached out, and they were like, "Oh, one of my friends was on Love Island, and they did really well, and they wanted to work with you." So they're quite big on Instagram, and I'm quite big on Facebook. So they're like, "They want to do a video on your Facebook, and they'll help you grow your Instagram."
Huh.
So I was like, "Okay, this sounds really good." So it started off, and it was like really well, and we started talking, and she was really nice, and then she was like, oh, "Okay, before we collab, can you just do all of this stuff for me?" And it was like ridiculous. So she had this app coming out. This might give away who it was. She had this app coming out, and she was like, "Oh, can you just do all of this free promotion and like these dedicated videos?" And it wasn't a collab. It just turned into like me doing lots of free work for her. And then when we started talking about doing a collab, I got ghosted again.
Oh my God. Did you feel like it's because they didn't understand you and your work and what
Well, I just thought it was weird because she approached me. So I would have thought that she'd know what I...
Did she come directly? Or was that with
the manager? No. So it was, she talked to a mutual friend. I'm guessing that she must have seen something I was doing on Facebook and thought, oh, it'd be cool to collab.
Right.
I had some really good ideas and I sent over some like comedy sketch ideas and I was like, here's what we can do on your Instagram. Here's what we can do in this Facebook. This is like, we can make it work. And yeah, it was very one-sided. So I think you need to be careful. If you're reaching out to someone, I kind of feel like you have the power. But if someone's reaching out to you and they're bigger than you, just make sure they don't use you.
And to make sure it's all above board and you've
opened it.
That's very solid advice.
The YouTube algorithm makes it really hard to find other small creators, and though I am on a forum, I can't find anyone who does the same thing as me. So what would your tip be on finding people you can actually collaborate with?
So finding people who are on a similar level to you,
go
who
to
make
YouTube
similar
gatherings.
Content. Go what?
YouTube gatherings. Go to YouTube gatherings.
Ah.
That's how we did it back in the day.
Or I used to go on my VidStats, rest in peace, and it would have like a list of
where
you are.
What happened to VidStats? I forgot about that.
It's now all about Social Blades. VidStats is down like forever.
I'm
upset, I know.
Sorry.
But there used to be a list where you'd see like the number of subs you'd have, and then the people 10 above and 10 below.
Ah.
So you could see like these are people around your size.
Social Blade has that too.
You can see that on Social Blade.
Oh, well, use Social Blade, but it's great because I used to just see random accounts that I've never heard of, click them, be like, oh, this is so cool. This is an account I've never even heard of, and they had good content. But that's what I'd recommend in terms of just finding new people, or just search on YouTube.
And also see who your viewers are also watching. So like, there's a fantastic... No. There's a fantastic musician called Cave Town who I found out of because a bunch of people who I follow followed him. And but people who watch me followed him. And he's fantastic. And so you can find out what your audience would be interested in seeing by seeing what they already like.
You could literally ask your audience, too. You could just pose it as a question. Who would they like to see you collab with that, you know, is around the same following as you? And, like, they will...
Whenever me and Evan do that, it's just Dan and Phil.
Someone that's not tall, lives in London, doesn't have a black fringe. Dan and Phil?
Okay, thanks.
You can talk to so many people. Don't just like go to YouTubers. Just mix amongst yourselves and actually get talking to other people. Like all of you have a common interest. Point one, done, tick. So maybe actually use this event as a networking opportunity. I think that's better.
Also remember that everyone is kind of... when if you're nervous about approaching someone, odds are they're nervous about approaching someone too.
Oh gosh, absolutely, yeah.
And yeah, the fact that you both have a common interest is great. Yeah.
That's literally how I started. Yeah. Started going to these sort of things, chatting to people, and it grew my confidence actually because everyone was on the same page and we used to help each other out, little group networks and things, and little WhatsApp groups, you know, little things like that. And I always think that sharing your knowledge is the most powerful thing. I think if you just keep it to yourself, that like, you're never going to grow. So if you've got like a little community of your own, like for like-minded people, then that's the best thing.
A lot of times when people are trying to collaborate, they're looking for people who are bigger fish than them. And it doesn't necessarily matter how many people are going to watch your content when you're first starting out. It's really about who's watching it. Like when I first started out, I collaborated with a really small influencer, and it just happened to have, and just because I really liked the work they were making, and it just happened that someone from Red Bull was watching their account, and the next day I was jumping out of a plane, landing at a spring break party in South Padre, Texas, and being the first person to ever Snapchat while jumping from 12,000 feet, wow. Just because they watched me in a video that was only getting like, that only got like, I think 4,000 views. But like, so it doesn't matter how many views you're getting. It matters who's watching it. So always, Cedra, what you were saying earlier, does like always make your best content, mm-hmm. Because it doesn't matter if that video is going to get, you know, 1,000,000 views, 10,000 views, or 100 views. It matters if someone who's watching it believes in what you're doing.
I always think expectation is important as well. So if you're just starting out and you want to, and you look at YouTube accounts that have been going for like 7 years and they're doing amazing, that's an unrealistic expectation. So if you, then you don't get the whole, you know, feeling bad, like I want to quit attitude. If you actually keep your goals at a realistic level, I think that's another really nice little stepping stone. Like there's no way you're going to be the next Zoella overnight. There's absolutely no way that's going to happen.
So challenge accepted.
I know it's a challenge accepted, but it's just be real with your goals.
What you were saying about people always aim for someone bigger than them. I think in the same way, people always aim to have a video on the bigger person's channel, whereas actually I think, especially these days with YouTube and the algorithm recommending things based on what you're already interested in, say I had Dan and Phil on my channel, ooh, that would probably do me just as,
yes,
well as if I was on Dan and,
yeah,
Phil's channel,
it really,
because
is, yeah,
I would get recommended to Dan and Phil's viewers, even though they're only on my channel. So often you might target someone who's bigger than you, and just so that you're not asking too much, ask them just on your channel, and you may well get a lot out of that.
Yep, I agree. Yep. It works.
Have you guys ever considered, or have you ever collabed with your parents? And like, what would they think?
Collab with our parents?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've filmed my parents before.
How was that?
It's fun because they like, they're just funny on camera because they're like not in.
Do they understand what you do?
They do, but right, they don't understand like our generation's like lingo and stuff, I guess. So like they don't, it's funny to see them like try and see what I'm talking about, I guess.
Yeah, I did the same thing with my parents. It was like a brand deal, and it was doing Urban Dictionary with my dad.
God.
So it was like all of these slang words, and my dad is really funny anyway, and it's like one of my favorite videos that I've ever done, just asking him these terms that we use all the time, and he was getting everything so wrong. Like, I'm so glad that he was born when he was and not now, because he'd probably have no friends. Like, no one would know what he's talking about.
Also, if he was born now, then you probably wouldn't,
yeah,
be here.
Yeah, wouldn't be born.
Like,
be
logistically,
here.
That would
but,
be.
No, I think, like, collabing with your parents and family members is really good, because people are watching your channel because they're interested in you and your personality, and obviously your family is kind of an extension of that. So even if your parents don't really understand what you do, get them involved, because it'll be funny.
Yeah.
Yeah, and hey, that's easy to ask your parents to collab. Like, I'm not worried about them saying no. So when in doubt, ask your parents.
Or your siblings. I was on a panel earlier, and it was girls that collaborated with their best friend and sisters. And let's just say, like, I did a Primark haul, it'd get good views. But if you did it with your sister or your best friend, oh my gosh, it explodes. And don't, you know, it doesn't just have to be another collaborator. It can be with your family, your best friends. Start there actually, and then you can actually like take that video to the next creator that you approach. You'd be like, I've done one with my sister. This is how I am with them. Like, are you interested that way? I mean, that's another good option.
My family never really liked YouTube. They didn't understand what I was doing, and I used to get bullied a lot in my household for doing it. And so I had come up with an idea to make a video, and it was like a sketch, and I'd have my mom in it, you know, poking fun at me, and she had a nice time at it. And I think after that, she understood it a bit more because she saw that I really enjoyed it. And also, like, I made a video about my dad once, and it was really relatable, and so...
It's kind of a good way to introduce them to your...
It's a really good way to introduce people, like, you know,
to what you do.
My content.
Have you guys ever done anything like that? And do you have any advice?
I like that question.
I've done like 50 collabs like that. When I was first starting out, I only collabed like over the internet like that before. So I used to make like music videos, so that worked really well. But also like comedy sketches work. Me and Connor Franta did one online. Like we each filmed like scenes for the sketch and like we edited it together. So it's hard to do like a sit-down collab, obviously. Like trying Foreign Candy, that won't work. But if you have like a comedy sketch or like a more creative idea where you have like different scenes, that really works. Like, I used to do that all the time.
Sketches are like the best way to do that. I had one, I think, last month in which I just really needed someone that's name was Daniel J. Layton to say something in my video. And so I just texted like, hey, can I get like a 5-second clip of you reading this line? And so sent it to me within a minute, got him in the video. It was really nice and he contributed and I felt great about it. So
you are very welcome.
Thank you. But yeah, it's really easy as long as you give them a quick line or something in a sketch where they can just film it against a white background or whatever you need. And yeah, it's a nice way to get an easy collab.
Yeah, I was going to say the same, like comedy sketches is the easiest way. One thing that a lot of people do is if there's a sketch with like a phone conversation, so you have you on one end of the phone, them on the other end of the phone, and obviously it's like a different background, but I've seen so many people do that and I've done that a few times and it works really well.
Cool.